Hey, are you familiar with some certain shots in badminton where you use the wrist like this and maybe have some pain in your wrist? Well, you've come to the right tutorial because I will show you how to use it the right way in many different situations on court. So, why is it so important to use the wrist the right way? First off, you won't be able to use your forearm rotation and your full arm rotation and probably also your body rotation because it only happens here, like you can see in the wrist. So I'm not using my full potential to get more power and position in many, many shots. That is why it's so important to have the correct grip on the racket in these different situations on court. If you have the right grip, it will be easier for you to add the right technique, to use the forearm rotation, and also to add more power to your shots. And lastly, it's also not that comfortable to use the wrist like this. It's not natural for our wrist to move with this movement like this. So it's really more natural to use your arm. It's much more comfortable on court and it's much more consistent and comfortable for you to do different types of shots. So let's get going with five different shots where we do it the wrong way and also do it the right way. And the first one is the overhead shots. You will see some clips of me doing some clears and some smashes, but just briefly want to show you here before we go into those clips. So the wrong way with the overhead shots, that would be to use it like this. As you can see from the side, it's only my wrist that is doing the shot. So I won't have any power at all from my arm and my rotation in my upper body. So that is the wrong way, and it can give you a lot of pain because we need to add a lot of power to these shots. And the wrong grip for these overhead shots would also be the hammer grip, so you can bend the wrist. If you change to the forehand grip, it's much more tricky for you to do it the wrong way because your racket position is like this. So now we need to add the rotation in your forearm, also in the shoulder, to do it correctly. So that is the right way to do it. Add the right grip and the forearm rotation. And the next one is the backhand drive, the flat pushes where you really want to add a lot of power. So of course, once again, if you use the wrist like this, it would be the backhand power, the flat drives. It's really, really not comfortable for me to do this shot and I won't be able to add any power. So it's the same thing going again about the grip, forearm rotation, have the correct grip using the thumb and then rotate your forearm to add the power. It's much more natural, it's much more comfortable and much more powerful. next shot is a very delicate shot. So here we really need to nurture the small details to do it precise and to do it correctly. And that is the low serve. In the low serve, it's more easy for you to use the wrist because you won't have to use all that power because it's a very delicate and smooth shot. But still, it's a little bit inconsistent and not natural for you to do the serve. I will show you here the backhand serve. So if you use the wrist like this, as you can see here, I am holding the wrong grip. I'm not using my thumb, I'm only using my wrist. So my thumb is being placed the wrong way. I haven't got that much control of what I'm doing. And it's very tricky for me to add the flick serve because I can't add power with the wrist. And actually, when you do the serve, you use your wrist a little bit more. You don't use the forearm rotation. But instead of using the wrist this way, you use it this way where it's more comfortable, where you still can add some power if you want to do the flick serve. And the next one, that is the lift from the front of the court to the baseline. That could be high, could be more flat. All the same thing goes here for the lift. If you have the wrong grip, you will probably use the wrist too much, like I'm doing here. If you have the right grip, the forehand grip, it's more easy and more natural for you to do the forearm rotation in your lift in the forehand side. Same goes over in the backhand side. If you have the wrong grip, you will probably hold something like this with the bevel or on the side, and you will use your wrist like this. But when we change it around using the thumb, it's more easy once again. Add the forearm rotation, add all the power using your thumb. And the last one, number five here in this video, that is the backhand slice to the net, further into court, or maybe the high backhand. In all these shots down here, if you use the wrist, it will be very tricky for you to control what you're doing, and it will be almost impossible for you to add power to that backhand shot. So if you go down here and hit the shuttle like this, only using the wrist, you won't be able to add power and position to those shots. So it's extremely important to use your arms rotation, like we talked about in the other shots as well. Of course, the wrist is working a little bit, but really try not focusing on doing like this. This will be very tricky for you to control, and I will show you in the clips and also the GoPro. So in general, just to sum it up, you've seen these five different shots and you can see it's much more comfortable, much more powerful for me when I have the correct grip in the different kinds of shots, and also when I use the forearm rotation. So in general, you can say that try focusing on the grip, have the wrist in a natural and neutral position, so you can rotate your forearm with this move. That will give you more precision, more consistency, and also more power in your shots. So that was some tips about the wrist. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you can see the many different kinds of things I'm doing in the shots and in the GoPro clips. Train it a lot, focus on this a lot to improve your game. It really, really helps you when you have the correct grip and use your forearm rotation. So thanks a lot for tuning in. Thanks a lot for following us. Hit the subscribe button if you are not following us yet. And just have a wonderful day and see you next time. Bye.